Hey guys, welcome back to another Justice League themed tutorial. Last week, Zach showed you how to turn yourself into Cyborg using HitFilm Express and Blender. And today we're going to be taking a look at how to create Superman heat vision effects, as seen in the Snyder Cut. This is a really simple effect at its very core, so I'm going to take you through some of the other things that we considered when we were filming and creating this piece. You can also find the project file for this effect down in the description. The first thing, of course, is actually filming the clip. We shot at a low angle so we can make myself look taller. And I've positioned two lights on either side of myself to match what will eventually become the background, which is a portal sort of made of light, and hopefully it looks like it's shining directly on my face. We also had an LED that we turned to the color red, and we had Tom off screen turn the light on at the right time. Even though it looks cool in frame, we didn't actually end up needing the red light in the final composite because the lights and the glows are so blown out that you can't even see my face anymore. So it's better to have it and not need it in the end than the other way around. As you can see, I shot myself on a green screen, and because my hair was so messy and all the strands are pointing in different directions, I wanted to make sure that we got those details in the final composite. So inside of HitFilm, I brought in my footage and masked out any areas that weren't necessary in the final shot. Then for the green screen itself, I used two different chroma key effects. One for my torso and neck, where the details on the edges weren't as important, and one on my hair itself, where I needed it to be a bit softer and have more detail. I did this by putting the chroma key effects on two different grade layers and masking them out where they were needed. The background is actually made up of just a single stock photo. I knew that there wasn't going to be any camera motion on my plate, so it wasn't important that the background have parallax or any sort of 3D movement. I found a picture of some rocks on pexels.com, which is free, and then used curves and various color grading effects to darken it down and take out the color. For the sparks and smoke, I used action VFX stock footage and set the blend mode to add. The portal is just some fractal noise that I've masked out into a circle shape, and then I used a lens blur effect to get rid of all of the details so that you can't see exactly how it's made. The depth of field is important for matching the sort of high contrast Zack Snyder look that we were going for. The lens blur effect gets you much more realistic results compared to something like the regular blur. The specular threshold and the specular brightness settings can create more bright spots to give visual interest. Also try raising the opacity curve setting. This will create a dark spot in the middle of the bokeh, which can give it a bit of texture. Now for the actual lasers themselves, I'm going to create a plane layer and first add a radial gradient effect. I'll set the blend of the plane itself to screen for a less harsh effect. I'll set the blend to add and adjust the size so that it covers my eyes. You won't see the result of this right away, but what it does is blow out the details to make it look more like the trailer. I'll change the outer radius color to orange and the inner radius to white if it's not there already. Next, I'll add a diffuse effect to soften it quite a bit, and then we can add the actual beams themselves, which I'll do using the Light Sword Ultra effect. If you're using HitFilm Express but haven't bought the add-on, you can use the regular Light Sword effect. You'll just get a slightly different result. Using either the settings in the controls panel or the controls on screen, I'll move the light sword effects to be pointing in the direction that I want. One thing that I noticed from the trailer I was referencing was that the light sword effects turn on in a single frame. There's no growth or extension or anything, they just snap on from one frame to the next. So I did the same thing in my version. Under the core settings, you have options for distortion, so you can choose energy, heat, smoke, or whatever fits the look you're going for. I'll add a little bit of distortion so that the beam isn't perfectly straight. And I'm actually going to turn off the glow for both these light sword effects so that I can control them with one single glow. First, add a demult effect, and then use the light sword ultra glow effect. I'll change the inner glow to a pale orange, and the outer to a more red. These effects also have flicker settings, so if you need it to automatically go up and down over time, you can do that here. Then I'll add two regular glow effects with the blend set to screen, and adjust those so that it blows out the light in the frame. Again, I was matching the look of the trailer here, where you can't see any detail once the laser beams have been activated. But if you don't like the look of so much glow, you can customize it the way you want. And that's pretty much it. Like I said at the beginning, it's a very simple effect conceptually, and the result comes from the background and the compositing that you do on the green screen layer. For the final color grade on top of everything, I used a couple different grading effects, like curves, bleach bypass, lens dirt using a custom texture, some film grain, and a little bit of shake when I do the punching motion. If you guys have any questions about this effect, feel free to leave them down below or check out the project file in the description. If you missed last week's tutorial, Zach showed you how to create the Cyborg effect. Next week, we'll be showing you how to create a Flash effect, so by the end of this, you'll have Cyborg, Superman, and Flash tutorials so that you can assemble your own Justice League. Be sure to subscribe if you haven't already so that you don't miss that. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you all in the next video.